Hey guys, this is Sherry talking, and we're back for another video on this channel. This time I'll be talking about the Arbiter of the Mice event. This event got released in around 1 day and 20 hours ago, but I'm just releasing this video now because there's just so many content that I kinda don't know what to do most of the time because, well, the game has now 4 events that will have farming types. 3 now, but we'll get Valhalla South pretty soon, so that's why I'm saying this. But I'll try to just get all my content aligned as soon as I can finish the Valhalla South event. Okay, so now we need to talk about the Arbiter of Demise. And before we talk about the Arbiter of Demise, I want to tell you guys that don't start this event yet if you didn't. Why? Because if you still have things to farm on Revenge of the Sinner, just do it, because the character that it's used here is Aelia and Wildfred. You can just do all the things with Aelia, because Aelia is just so powerful here, you don't really need Wildfred. I have my videos on this channel explaining how I defeat this boss here. It's just so easy most of the time. And then, well, I'm saying this because Arbiter of Demise event really depends on having Arbiter Hearst very powerful and reliable to clear content, because the content here is a little harder than the Revenge of the Sinner, and you can do just so much damage with Arbiter of Demise that Arbiter Hearst, that you can just use your other characters as support. You can just bring buffs, heals and tanks and just let Hearst do the damage. So before we talk about why this girl does just so much damage, I need to go to the notice and explain some things about this event. And well, let me click here. The first thing I want to talk about is the... let me click here. Arbiter of Demise. So you see that this event has 2 parts, the one that started already and the one that will start on the 5th of September. And there's a lot of things here that they say. The first thing is that Arbiter Hearst will increase the drop rate of the first part. So she's a character, she can only be used once, and the increase in drop is not that important. But the second part, the thing that will increase the drop rate is Salve. The drop rate is called Salve, and Arbitora is the weapon for Hearst that you can summon on the Divine Weapon, and you can use multiples to just farm stuff and wait till the event is close to end, and just fuse your weapon later. But the first part is just Arbiter Hearst that increases drops. And if you don't have Arbiter Hearst, you don't have nothing to increase the drop rate of this event. And, well, they talk about the titles. I don't care about titles. And then they mention the centerpiece items. I won't be talking about this now because, well, I want to show you guys the shop. And there's the second part as well. Okay. Before we delve into that, let's just give a look on the Divine Weapon soon. First of all, Yume is included just like Arbiter Hearst. Arbiter Hearst is just so much of a strong character in the game that she's kind of a new level of overpower. She's the best character in the game so far. There is no deny on this. But I want to explain why. This character is the last character released in Japan. When you compare to others, she's the most future character in Japan when compared to the ones that we got released. And I was not expecting Arbiter Hearst to be released so soon, because we got Creation Valkyrie, then we got Volcar Alicia, then we got Supreme Deity Odin together with Wildfred. Then it's a very popular character. Not many people like Wildfred because he's just not a good protagonist on the game, but he's still a protagonist, so I didn't expect Arbiter Hearst to just come soon. I saw the image where they teased that they could possibly release Arbiter Hearst, and that's where I started to think that it was really something that would happen. And well, Arbiter Hearst is strong, and I'll explain why. But when you click on the tail, you will have to understand that she's a half-generation character. She's the second generation. She's somewhere among the middle to near end of second generation characters. And her passives are just so very fine. She can increase attack, but also dark attacks on the first passive. She can increase damage of all types as well. And also she increases damage and attack of all allies without any restriction. Like I said with Odin, he needs a purification bar of level 1 for his skill to work. Arbiter Hearst doesn't need this. Some characters won't need any type of restriction to have this. And she also has limited skill and extra skill. This girl has so much things for her. The first thing you see is that she increased the purification attack damage. It's the same thing as Aelia. Imagine Aelia in the Revenge of the Sinner event, the amount of damage that she can inflict. This is the same thing happens with Arbiter Hurst. She can do just a lot of damage because she's back on here, she has more damage, and she also can use the weapon from the event to bust the damage even further. You can get 400 plus damage, 200 coming from Arbiter Hurst and 200 coming from the weapon. And she also increases more because of the purification attack damage increase. She can increase even more the damage of the weapon because of her extra skill. She's the first character in the game, at least for Global, to have extra skill imbued with her. So she will increase it even further the action skill damage. Like I said, this girl is the only thing that you need to clear all the stages in this event. And that's why I recommend you to wait if you don't have strong friends with her. And I'll be also updating my list with strong players and posting on Reddit and here as well, so you can get more strong players. I always do this when I start the Valhalla Assault event. Well, and what more information, she also gets the, like I said, the drop rate for the first part of the event is only Hurst. And she also gets double experience. Also, something that's starting to happen is that you also get more 30% increase of the experience if you equip the unique orb. Just more incentive to keep summoning and getting your orbs. So, okay, and what I have to talk about Yuumi? I don't have nothing to talk about Yuumi, because Yuumi was not on this event on Japanese version. So she has nothing for here. She's not even from the correct element of the weakness of the enemies. The enemies are weak to darkness and lightning. This girl is ice. She only gets more experience if you equip her unique orb. All other things here, she doesn't have a 50 page. You see, she increases, but she's still so much strong that she's one of the best ice mages in the game, even comparing Japanese version. She's very safe to invest, one of the best mages in the game, because she has this Mother Ocean, and Mother Ocean is one of the best passives for support. It increases defense, mag defense, and also increases the resistance to status ailment, excepting this special status. The special status that means something like Seal. And she also has extra skill. This girl also has it. She has limited skill that also increases mag for allies, and Ice Blessing increases the normal attack of her ice attacks. So it's very incredible. Very incredible. This character here is just, we didn't have any strong ice mage. We will be getting Maya in the future. She's free, she's from Valhalla, so she can't compare to this character at all. Okay? So Yuumi is very strong. She's like I said, she's close to this end of the second generation of characters in Japan. And she kind of feels for it. You may not see it when looking at her status, because she doesn't really hit 2000 mag, but don't fret, don't mind about it. She's one of the best characters in the game, even being a sorcerer. But I'll be doing a review on these characters later. And then we have the weapon. Well, the weapon. Albitora is just a very strong weapon because it deals extreme damage. It's not severe damage. It's the last step in the evolution, the last weapons we got also with Supreme Deity Odin and Wirefred, and we have this weapon doing the same thing. And this weapon has something that it's not expressed here, and the thing is that this weapon also has an extra skill. So the extra skill that it has is the same extra skill as Hurst has. So you can use the weapon to increase it even further, or just use the weapon that you will just clash, but it won't happen, nothing will happen out of it. But just use it as your main weapon. Why would you fuse it? You're an all whale, or are you? So the physical ward hit is great for a great sword, and also the damage, like I said, it's just that is an increased purification gauge on the start of your turn. This is the original passive skill for common Hurst, and this kind of gives her this passive skill to just make it even better, but it's not that important. And that's why some people were saying this weapon is just, oh, this is just so good, because it has an extra skill. Okay, it has an extra skill, but Hurst already has the extra skill. And you don't really need this weapon because the passive is not that important. Even if the damage is extreme, we'll very soon get more and better weapons. So, you, like I said, this weapon will give you more drop rates on the second part of the event. 25 for each Kopai you have on your main one hand, or 12 if you have it on your sub-weapon slot. Okay? So we'll talk about this part of the event, and now we'll have to talk about other things. Like I said, all of the content can be solved by this girl. You because if you get a friend, let me try to see if I can get a friend using the weapon as well. This girl will be very popular from here on out. The damage she inflicts is just so high, she's beautiful, the animation is very well done, and all the things. You see that, look, I already have two people here using her and also the Albitoran weapon. Having the weapon maximum limit broken will be enough to deal with all the content, but having the action skill leveled make it even easier. Level 3 can one-shot the boss from the 90k staging. You don't even need this to be maxed, okay? Just so you can understand how important it is to have this girl here. It's even more important than when Creation Valkyrie was released and the event that you had Creation Valkyrie, you also had Hakuri. But the two together were not strong or important as this girl here alone. She can solo all the content here. So that's why I'm recommending you guys to just use her to do damage and you just bring support. And okay, if you have her already, just bring another one and two Arbiter Hearst will just destroy everything. Even when the event ends, she will still be the strongest character in the game. There was just one thing I didn't talk about her, and it's... I will save for my review on her. I will release the review tomorrow. I don't know the time of the day, probably around this time, in 24 hours from now. Sadly, I can't release reviews as fast as I can, because I'm a free-to-play player, and I didn't choose the path of being a YouTube content creator to just have glory or something like that. I want to be this a part of my revenue. I need it to be. That's the truth of this. And Wonder Planet didn't support me anyway so far, so I can't purchase gems and have my only source of gems is what the game gave me, and I can't keep summoning every time. So people keep asking me, will you summon share when this banner comes out? I won't. Only when I have 48k gems or 43k gems or 45, something like that. That's when I will summon, probably 2 months from now. That's what happens. And I'll be having to use rerolls. I'll have to use another players with other characters to test the character so I can make a review. Well, Wonder Planet still doesn't think my content is worth giving support, even though someone already got it from the start of the game. I won't be complaining here, I'll keep doing my stuff. One day something will happen. I wish it happened faster so I can keep producing content and making it as fast as possible. So having to reroll content is just terrible for me, I'm a waste of my time. So okay, let's back to the event itself. The Arbiter of Demise, like I said, these are the stages. You can clear everything with just one run if you have a very strong Hearst, and then you have to farm a lot on this event because the rewards are very good. But will you have the time to farm it? I really think they kinda did too much this time. We'll be having 4 events going on at the same time, and you won't be able to just get everything if you don't use all your AP pods or something like that. And then we have the Yggdrasil branch is recommended. The Key of Guidance can be skipped because not many people can soul sublimate their cards already. You may be having something on this already and you didn't use. The Legendary Rainbow Stone is recommended. Pulmonia can be skipped, but it's the best one of the bunch that we had so far, but still not usable. We had a lot of bones with the lightning element. Sorry guys, there is a dog barking and I can't make it stop. Then we have the extra skill weapon. This is very recommended. I really recommend this weapon here. And then we have the Silver Scroll and Bronze Scroll. These are used to level up the extra skill that you can imbue your characters with. So don't miss these things. Skip all the gems that are used to increase the limit break of your character. Get the Fury Orb. You see that it has 90 points of orbs, rune orb. So this is one of the best ones. It's just like a 7-star orb, but being 6-star and unique with a different type of skill. I didn't check it yet. Then we have Awakening Ember, you have to get it. Divine Weapon Ticket Gold can be skipped, Awakening Pearl can be skipped. If you are a veteran, you really have to get the Nameless Hero Memory as well. Then you see that the Nameless Hero Memory 4 is not pricey. You can still get it if you are planning to farm this event and if you have Hearst to increase the drop rate. Okay, all other stuff are not that important. The Volcar Memory can be important if you had Hearst, and everything else can be skipped. you will get a lot of hammers when farming Valhalla Assault. Don't get hammers from here, okay? And like I said, first finish this Revenge of the Sinner event and get everything from here and wait your friends to get stronger so you can get stronger as well and use their Arbiter Hearths to defeat all the content here. The best place to farm, don't know if I talked about this yet, will be the Challenge 3. If you can't defeat it because Arbiter Hearths is not enough, just focus on Challenge 2. You can also get triple drops on this event, okay? That's it, guys. There's nothing more for me to talk. I'll be doing a review tomorrow of this character, and just like with Yume, if I can have the time for it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. I really need your help, okay? We see each other on the next video. Bye.